Have you ever been concerned about losing your data because of a physical disk failure? Or have you ever been in a situation that your hard drive is running out of space and you don't know how to add space to it? Today, in this short video, I'm going to show you how to use one of the built-in Windows features to overcome these two issues. Windows storage space is one of the built-in features in Microsoft Windows. It is available in Windows 10, 11, and Windows Server. In Windows Server Data Center Edition, it is called Storage Space Direct. I will create a separate video for that. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Storage Space is technically storage virtualization technology. It groups multiple disks together and presents them to the operating system as a single disk. It is similar to RAID, but it's implemented in the software. What you can do with the storage space is group multiple disks, present them as a pool, and then create storage spaces from that pool and present it to Windows. What operating system will see is just one independent disk, but you know that on the background, it is highly available. I will show you on the video how many options do you have for the availability and the resiliency. My name is Ali, and in this short video, I'm going to show you how to use Windows storage space. Let's talk about some high-level concepts. Traditionally, if you have a server, let's imagine this is our server, and we have our hard disks installed. Traditionally, if we wanted to have more than one physical disks, we had to use something called a RAID controller. Yes, you can, depending on the number of ports that your computer has, you can add maybe 2, 3, or 4 hard disks to your server. Or even if you have a blade server, they might have all the way up to 24 slots for hard disks. But still, for some cases, it is not enough. And if you need to add more disks, you have to use some sort of external hardware, such as RAID controllers. RAID controllers allow you to combine 2, 3, or 4 disks and present them to the operating system as one larger physical disk. This is an expensive piece of hardware and it's not easy to maintain. Now, if you have more than 2 or 3 disks, then even a simple RAID controller will not help. We have other technologies as well. We have a technology called JBOD, or just a bunch of disks. JBOD is technically a physical hard case that you can install 20, 30, or 40, depending on the size of your JBOD, hard disks into that box. What it does, it allows you to connect more than one physical disk to your computer. Now that you have connected all these physical disks to your computer, how do we manage them? Imagine that your computer is connected to a JBOD and this JBOD has over 20 hard disks. Just one example. Imagine you have 20 hard disks, 1 terabyte each. Now, in total, you have a pool of 20 terabytes. But if you include these disks in your operating system individually, Windows can only create 20 partitions that has 1 terabyte each. What if you have a data that is 10 terabytes? You cannot split it across these 10 drives, and you cannot combine these drives together by default. Storage space is a technology that allows you to replace the RAID controllers and implement those RAIDs inside the operating system as a software. What it does, it allows you to combine all these disks and any more disks that you can add to the pool later, and then create a virtual disks from this pool. Let's take a look at the operating system and see how we can achieve that. From the Start menu, search for the storage spaces and select Manage Storage Space. In the Manage Storage Spaces window, start creating the pool by selecting Create a New Pool and Storage Space. Select all the disks that you would like to add to the pool. Select a name and click Create Pool. You can always rename your pool later. A storage pool is a collection of one or more physical disks that you can use to create virtual disks. You can add all non-formatted physical disks or any other disk that is not linked to another pool to a new storage pool. In this example, I will select three disks and create pool by clicking Create Pool. Once you create your pool, the wizard immediately prompts you to start the process of creating the storage space. I'm going to click Cancel for now to explore the other options. We will come back to creating the storage space later. Now you can see that your pool is created. You can see the list of the disks that are in your pool. You can see the total capacity of your pool, which is equal to the sum of all the disks in the pool. You can rename the pool, delete it, or add more disks to the pool. Let's rename our pool. When renaming pools and storage spaces, it is always best to select meaningful names that you or other users can relate to. For example, I'm selecting High Performance Pool or Gold Pool. This will help me in the future to remember I have added high performance disks to this pool, and I would use it for production environments or more demanding applications. You might want to create several pools like Gold, Silver, Bronze, or any other naming convention that you're comfortable with. Now, let's start creating a storage space. Storage space is similar to a physical disk from the perspective of a user or the programs. However, storage spaces are more flexible because they include thin provisioning, aka just-in-time allocation, and they include resiliency to physical disk failures with built-in functionality such as mirroring. Click Create a Storage Space, give your storage space a name, and select the desired drive letter and file system. It is always best to follow the same naming convention as your pool, or something similar to your pool. Your next decision is your disk resiliency type. A simple storage space has data striping but no redundancy. In data striping, logically sequential data is segmented across all disks in such a way that provides access for these sequential segments to different physical storage drives. Striping makes it possible to access multiple segments of data concurrently. In a simpler word, simple storage space spreads your data across multiple physical disks, and this will give you a higher capacity than a single physical disk, but no redundancy. Do not host important data on a simple volume, because it provides no failover capabilities. When the disk that is storing the data fails, you will lose your data. Two-way and three-way mirrors maintain two or three copies of the data that they host. Two copies for two-way and three copies for three-way mirror. Data duplication happens with every write to ensure that all data copies are always current. Mirror spaces also stripe the data across multiple physical disks. Mirror spaces do not introduce a risk of corrupting at rest. Your data is by far safer on a two-way or three-way mirror. A parity is similar to RAID 5. Storage space stores data along with parity information striped across multiple physical disks. Parity enables storage spaces to continue servicing read and write requests even when a drive has failed. Parity always rotates across available disks to enable I/O optimization. Storage spaces require a minimum of three physical drives for parity spaces. When you select any of the resiliency types, you will see the available capacity will change. For this example, I'm going to create a storage space with parity resiliency and use the maximum size available in my pool. Select your desired parameters and click Create a Storage Space. Now you can see your first storage space is created and placed under your pool. Congratulations! If you open your My Computer or this PC, you can see the new drive is available for use. Now let's add more disks to the pool. Under your pool, click Add Drives and select the disk you would like to add to your pool. Click Add Drives. After a few seconds, you'll notice that your pool capacity is increased. And now, if you want, you can go ahead and add more room to your storage space. For this example, I will increase my storage space to 150 GB. Checking my computer shows that our drive is now expanded. Let's check Disk Management Console. In Run, type in diskmgmt.msc and hit Enter. This will open Disk Management Console. If you'd like to learn more about Disk Management Console, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification icon to be notified when the new content is released. As you can notice, your storage space is presented as an independent disk to Windows. This means our operating system does not know what is behind this disk and will treat it as a normal physical disk. Now, what happens if one of the physical disks in your pool fails? Well, the answer is almost nothing. Depending on your resiliency selection, nothing would happen to your data with the exception of simple storage space. If you need to remove a disk from the pool or replace it with a new one, you can easily open the physical disks in your pool and select Prepare for Removal. This will move the data from the disk to empty spaces on other disks and prepare the disk for removal. Once the system has prepared the disk, you can safely remove it or replace it with a new one of the same or larger capacity. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Also, leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to learn. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you on the next video.